Today I'm going to be telling you the story of Esther Cox, an 18-year-old Amherst resident who made national headlines in 1878 when she became the center of a peculiar series of paranormal events. These events have come to be known as the Great Amherst Mystery. Esther Cox was born on the 28th of March, 1860, in Upper Stewiacke, Nova Scotia, as the youngest of six children born to her father, Archibald, and her mother, whose name was also Esther. Sadly, her mother died from complications from Esther's birth just 3 weeks after she was born. Her father soon remarried and moved with his new wife to Maine, leaving Esther and her siblings to be raised by their grandmother in a deeply religious home. In 1878, when Esther was 18 years old, she was living on Princess Street in Amherst, Nova Scotia, with her older sister Olive and her sister's husband, Daniel Teed. She was known for being extremely stubborn and strong-willed, but otherwise well-liked and a great help to her sister, until, when shortly after being sexually assaulted by a man, who some sources say was a family friend and some say was a boyfriend, Esther started to change. The first incident happened late one evening in late August of 1878, when screams could be heard coming from Esther's bedroom. When others entered the room, Esther claimed that there was something moving under the blankets on her bed. This was quickly dismissed by her family members as her imagination going wild, and shortly after, everyone went back to bed. The following night, however, screams came from her room once again. This time, Esther claimed that they were banging and scratching noises coming from under her bed. The family removed a box of sewing scraps from underneath it, and to everyone's horror, the box suddenly flew across the room and crashed into the wall. From that moment on, it was assumed to be a poltergeist. Night by night, Esther continued to scream from her room, claiming that more of her belongings were being moved or thrown. Crashing and banging noises could be heard almost every night. Her health seemed to be declining as she was feeling more and more unwell by the day. Her body was red and feverish, and she was becoming weak. One night, after yet another attack by the poltergeist, Esther collapsed and went into a deep sleep. Her family called the local doctor, who came to visit her on several occasions but was unable to help her, though he did witness several of the paranormal events himself. As the months went by, the paranormal activity seemed to be happening more frequently and becoming more violent. The words, "Esther Cox, you are mine to kill," once appeared carved into the wall above her bed. Often, lit matches were found on beds and other furniture, causing small fires around the house. On one occasion, a small knife allegedly flew out of the pocket of a male visitor and stabbed Esther in the back. Esther was frequently pinched and poked, and furniture and dishes were repeatedly thrown around the house. In June of 1879, Esther was brought on a tour as somewhat of a sideshow act by an actor named Walter Hubble, who had been a boarder at her sister's home and witnessed much of the paranormal incidents. The tour was canceled after only two performances, which were held in New Brunswick, as they were met with a scared and disapproving audience. So Esther went back to her sister's home in Amherst, where the poltergeist continued to wreak havoc. Eventually, this became too much for Esther's sister, and she was forced to move several times to multiple boarding houses and other family members' homes. At one point, while living with another sister, Esther came down with a case of diphtheria, and it is said that during this time, all paranormal activity came to a halt. It wasn't until she was fully recovered that strange things began to happen, and because of this, locals started to believe that it was Esther herself who was causing these strange things to happen, and she faced quite a bit of public scrutiny. In one instance, in November of 1879, the barn belonging to the man she was boarding with at the time burned down, and Esther was charged with arson, spending 1 month in jail. After being released, all activity seemed to suddenly stop at once. She eventually married twice, moving with her second husband to Brockton, Massachusetts, where apparently no one knew of her paranormal past or fame. She died there in 1912. So what really happened to Esther Cox? Was it actually a poltergeist? Did she have supernatural powers of her own? Or did the sexual assault that she experienced cause some sort of psychotic break? There were several witnesses to many of these events, most of which were skeptics until they saw it with their own eyes. No matter what your opinion is on it, the story of Esther Cox and the Great Amherst Mystery is still to this day one of the most well-known instances of poltergeist activity in Canada.